Hey everyone, it's Julianna from Clarinet Note Studio, and in today's video I thought I would share what's in my clarinet bag, but more specifically what I keep in my accessory bag, which I use for every rehearsal and for every performance. So if that sounds interesting, just stick around. So I recently saw a documentary on HBO Max called Bama Rush. And it's a documentary that follows four young females and their sorority rush experience at the University of Alabama. And in the documentary, there's a girl, I believe her name is Shelby Rose, and they show her making a TikTok about what's in her rush bag. And she had everything in that bag from like an extra set of earrings to safety pins to gum. I mean, you name it, she had it in there.
I had back pain, they really helped me. Along that same line, Icy Hot, Tylenol, hand sanitizer, blister patches, since we're going to be wearing heels.
And it got me thinking, well, I kind of do something like that, but with my clarinet bag, I have my accessory bag. We'll call it my clarinet bag. And I keep things in here that helped lower my anxiety and help me feel prepared for rehearsals and performances, so I can feel confident that if something goes awry, I have it in my accessory bag. So first of all, I just use like a cosmetics bag. It's kind of bright, but you know, it makes me happy. You know, it's good to have around. But I will say, for performances, like you can't keep something like this on stage necessarily without, you know, drawing attention. So what I do is I use like a men's toiletry bag size that's, you know, black and will blend in with the stage. And then this bag will actually fit into this bag. And I can keep more things in here like my wallet and my car keys and my cell phone plus my accessory bag. Because sometimes the orchestra I play with, they don't want you to keep your purse on stage, you know, so I mean, I get it, but I also don't leave my purse backstage, you know, in the green room or anything. So anyway, I can leave some of these products linked. So first I have my reed case, and I actually have two of these reed cases. This reed case holds my best reeds. That's why I put the two stars on the outside. And when I open this up, I actually keep this microfiber tool from BG. That helps kind of eliminate the spit that collects in your tone holes. But I also have, always have a piece of this cigarette paper that helps, you know, dry out the tone holes when you need it. So I have these two reed cases. Of course, I always have a swab in there, right? This is really important, I think, for probably all woodwind players to have, but like a small screwdriver that you can use when the little screws start unwinding out of the clarinet, right? It's just good to have, you know, a screwdriver where you can immediately screw back in the screws. I can't tell you how many people have come to me, you know, do you have a screwdriver? I'm like, yes, I always have a screwdriver. Next would be something I think all clarinetists should probably have in their, you know, accessory case, would be a roll of Teflon tape. So this is used, you know, in plumbing to help, you know, thread on connections and help the water from stop running out. I use this for guarding a lot too. But anyway, what you can do with this is you can wrap it around any cork that's coming off, or if actually the cork has come off one of the joints of your clarinet, you can just easily wrap this on, tears off super fast. And I wanted to show that actually I'm using it on my mouthpiece right now because the cork is coming off. It works great, especially in a pinch. So, but if you don't have Teflon tape around, you can also use this Glide dental floss. It doesn't work as well as the Teflon tape, but you know, in a pinch, it's awesome. Next, I have cork grease. Of course, you never know when you're gonna need cork grease. I also have a lighter. So depending on, you know, what situation you're in, you know, whether you can have a lighter in your bag, you know, I guess would just depend. But this is great if like a pad starts coming out, you can sort of heat the metal underneath it and it will heat the glue up again. And then you can seat the pad back into that, into place there. I always have an extra ligature. You just never know, you know, especially with these newer ligatures, sometimes the screw will pop off, and it's just always good to have an extra ligature, I've found through experience. Also, I have a hand sanitizer because you just never know what you're going to be touching, you know, in performances or shaking people's hands. Always good to have around. Of course, for rehearsals and concerts, always good to have some pencils. Have those around. And let's see, what else do I have? Oh, a metronome. So, you know, I always have this around just to double check tempos and stuff. I also have a metronome that's like a combo of a metronome and a tuner. That's also great to have in your bag, you know, just to check pitch, you know. So that's good to have around. I also have just some extra reeds in my case there. And let's see what else. Oh, I also have safety pins, because if you're in a concert and like the hem of your pants or skirt, whatever you're wearing, starts to come unravel, you never know what's going to happen. I like to have those around too. Earplugs, just in case you're, I don't know, in front of the trumpet section. These are good to have around. I like to keep these little post-it tabs. In my case, these help out a lot, I find. If you have like a quick page turn, you can stick one of these tabs on the edge of that page, and it helps like sort of grip and stick out of the page. So you can do like a quick flip if you need to. Sandpaper, I always keep, I think this is 600 grit sandpaper, if I need to do some reed adjustments. So that's pretty much everything I keep in my accessory bag right now for performances and concerts. I also have another bag I take with me when I have to travel out of the area, and I might make another video about that. Maybe leave a note in the comments if you think that would be interesting. But also, I would love to know what everyone else keeps in their accessory bag. Anything that I don't have in my bag that you think would be necessary or helpful, you know, I think that would be great if you just left a note in the comments about, you know, what you find helpful. But I guess that's all I have for right now. I appreciate you clicking on this video and hanging out, and I'll see you all next time. Thanks.